Good morning, Salem Lutheran Church.
Good morning.
These are the hardy souls, right? The faithful remnant. Just be careful driving out there. We're glad you're here this morning. Today's live stream broadcast is given by you, the members of Salem. So welcome to Passion/Palm Sunday worship. Today we will be reading Mark chapters 14 and 15 in a dramatic reading fashion. So we thank our readers, Bruce Adams, Alan Willie Skellinger, as well as percussionist Hannah Sterenberg. We will remain seated through most of the worship service, and please look at the bulletin so you know when to stand or to be seated. Please know also that we will be singing certain verses of some of the songs, and they're designated in the bulletin for you also. And when we sing the processional hymn, All Glory, Lord, and Honor, you are invited forward, waving your palm branch and lay it on the foot of the cross. And it's up for discussion whether you think the people are really cheering on Jesus or are they being sarcastic. That's something that I wonder. So we begin our, let me remind you about Holy Week, first of all. Reminder that this is Maundy Thursday this week, and that's at 7 p.m. There will be three fifth graders who will be receiving First Communion, and they will be sharing a meal with their family before worship, and Pastor Steve is coming for Thursday and Friday. Good Friday worship also begins at 7, and please join these Holy Week worship services as we do prepare for the resurrection of our Lord on Sunday morning. So we begin our worship service with the call to worship.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest heaven.
Blessed
is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Blessed is the one who comes with healing and compassion.
Blessed is the one who comes with forgiveness and mercy.
Lord, rest your hand of healing on our hearts today.
Gracious Jesus, let us walk with you today. Amen. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it,' and will send it back here immediately." They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. Now those who wish to process with palms, you wave them in the air as you process and lay them at the foot of the cross. And you can do that as we sing the processional hymn.
Glory, Lord, and Lord.
Each day as he taught, he was reminded of the faithfulness of those in power, faithlessness of those in power. He saw corruption and oppression at every turn in the temple.
Lord Jesus, let us be aware of all that draws us from you as we walk on the path to the cross.
At supper one evening, he discharged one of the disciples, Judas, to go and do what he felt he must do. From the cross, he forgave the executioners and welcomed a thief to paradise. For the others, he gave a precious reminder of his love through the washing of their feet and through the sacrament of bread and wine. Gracious Lord, you come to us now to bring healing for our brokenness, peace for our troubled lives, hope for our doubting minds. You restore us and guide us along right pathways for your name's sake.
Amen. Amen.
Lord,
everlasting God, in your endless love for the human race, you sent our Lord Jesus Christ to take on our nature and to suffer death on the cross. In your mercy, enable us to share in his obedience to your will and in the glorious victory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Our first reading today is from Isaiah, the 50th chapter. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me, therefore I have not been disgraced. Therefore I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Who will declare me guilty? Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsive psalm will be from Psalm 31. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eye is consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly. I am the scorn of all my enemies, a disgrace to my neighbors, a dismay to my acquaintances. When they see me in the street, they avoid me. For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life. My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me.
Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me and your steadfast love.
Our second reading today is from Philippians chapter 2. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Word of God, word of life.
It was 2 days before the Passover and the festival of unleavened bread. The chief priests and the scribes were looking for a way to arrest Jesus by stealth and kill him.
For they said, "Not during the festival, or there may be a riot among the people."
Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray Jesus to them.
When they heard it, they were greatly pleased and promised to give him money.
So Judas began to look for an opportunity to betray Jesus.
On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb was sacrificed at evening, Jesus came with the 12. And when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said,
"Truly, I tell you, one of you will betray me, the one who is eating with me."
They began to be distressed and to say to him one after another, "Surely not I."
Jesus said to them, "It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me.
For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him, but woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born."
While they were eating, Jesus took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to them, and said, "Take, this is my body."
Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it.
Jesus said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I tell you, I will never drink again of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it in the new kingdom of God."
When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives.
And Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters, for it is written,
'I will strike the shepherd and the sheep will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee."
Peter said to him, "Even though all other become deserters, I will not."
Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this day, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
But Peter said vehemently, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you."
And all of them said the same.
Gethsemane, and Jesus said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray."
He took with him Peter and James and John and began to be distressed and agitated.
And Jesus said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here, keep awake."
And going a little further, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that, if it were possible, the hour might pass from him.
He said, "Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want."
Jesus came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, "Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour?
Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak."
And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words.
And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy. and they did not know what to say to him.
Jesus came a third time and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough! The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners.
Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand."
Immediately, while Jesus was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, and with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the scribes and elders.
Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard."
So when he came, he went up to Jesus at once and said, "Rabbi," and kissed him.
Then they laid hands on Jesus and arrested him.
But one of those who stood near drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear.
Then Jesus said to them, "Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit?
Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled."
Deserted him and fled.
A certain young man was following him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth.
They caught hold of him, but he left the linen cloth and ran off naked.
They took Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes were assembled.
Peter had followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest, and he was sitting on the guards warming himself at the fire.
Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none.
For many gave false testimony against him, and their testimony did not agree.
Some stood up and gave false testimony against him, saying, "We heard him say, 'I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another, not made with hands.'"
But even on this point, their testimony did not agree.
Then the high priest stood up before them and asked Jesus, "Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against you?"
But he was silent and did not answer.
Again the high priest asked him, "Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?"
Jesus said, "I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming from the clouds of heaven."
Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, "Why do we still need witnesses? You have heard this blasphemy. What is your decision?"
All of them condemned him as deserving death. Some began to spit on him, to blindfold him, and to strike him, saying to him, "Prophesy." The guards also took him over and beat him.
Thank you.
the servant girls of the high priest came by.
When she saw Peter warming himself, she stared at him and said, "You also are with Jesus, the man from Nazareth."
But Peter, denying it, said, "I do not know or understand what you are talking about." And he went out into the forecourt.
Then the cock crowed.
And the servant girl, on seeing him, began again to say to the bystanders, "This man is one of them."
But again, he denied it.
Then after a little while, the bystanders again said to Peter, "Certainly you are one of them, for you are a Galilean."
But he began to curse, and he swore an oath, "I do not know this man you are talking about."
At that moment, the cock crowed for the second time. Then Peter remembered that Jesus had said to him, "Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times."
And he broke down and wept. As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate.
Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He answered him, "You say so."
Then the chief priests accused him of many things.
Pilate asked him again, "Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you."
But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed.
Now at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked.
Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with the rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection.
So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them, "Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?"
For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priest had handed him over.
But the chief priest stirred up the crowd to have them release Barabbas for them instead.
Pilate spoke to them again, "Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?"
They shouted back, "Crucify him!"
Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?"
But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him!"
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them, and after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified.
And they clothed him in a purple cloak, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him.
And they began saluting him, "Hail, King of the Jews!"
They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him.
After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him.
They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus.
Then they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull.
And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it.
And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each would take.
It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews."
Please stand.
And with him they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left.
Those who passed derided him, shaking their heads and saying, "Aha, you who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross."
In the same way, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves and saying, "He saved others. He cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now, so that we may see and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also taunted him. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "Eli, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?"
When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "Listen, he is calling for Elijah."
And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down."
Then Jesus gave out a loud cry and breathed his last.
And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom.
Now when the centurion who stood facing Jesus saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, "Truly, this man was God's son."
Then Joseph brought a linen cloth, and taking down the body, wrapped it in the linen cloth and laid it in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock.
He rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, saw where the body was laid.
The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Oh,
You may be seated for the prayers. Trusting in God's promise to reconcile all things, let us pray for the church, the well-being of creation, and a world in need. Blessed One, today the church sings glad hosannas as we enter Holy Week. Prepare us to bear witness to Christ's suffering and death endured for our sake. Gather your people around the cross and comfort us with resurrection hope. Hear us, O God. Renew your good creation and protect the balance of life on earth. Encourage the work of foresters, scientists, arborists, gardeners, and river keepers. We pray for the health of pollinating insects, songbirds, and native plants. Hear us, O God. Establish peace and justice among the nations, especially in the Middle East, in Russia, in Ukraine. Hold to account any with authority to judge others. Grant that courts, legislatures, and local governments will serve with integrity and compassion. Hear us, O God. Bring hope to any who feel forsaken or forgotten. Make a way for refugees and asylum seekers. Reunite families enduring separation. We pray for any who are incarcerated, institutionalized, or in foster care, that they may know your love. Hear us, O God. Give energy and joy to our pastors, deacons, worship leaders, and musicians. Bless baptismal candidates, their sponsors, confirmands, and teachers. Watch over those who travel. Hear us, O God. Blessed One, our times are in your hand. Sustain us in discipleship throughout our lives and receive us into everlasting life. Hear us, O God. We pray for the families of Lou, Steph, Nate, and Courtney Lawrenson, Dennis Madsen, Janet Vinson, Alan and Sarah Manns, Austin Manns, Beverly Manns. Hear us, O God. Accompany us on our journey, God of grace, and receive the prayers of our hearts through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. You are the bread of life and the host of this meal. Bless these gifts that we have gathered that all people may know your goodness. Feed us not only with this holy food, but with hunger for justice and peace. We pray this in your name. Amen. And now let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Beloved, you are God's own people, holy, washed and renewed. God bless you and keep you, shower you with mercy, fill you with courage, and give you peace. Amen. Amen.
Thanks be to God.